You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Tuesday, March 3rd, 2020. It is also the feast day of a great American saint, St. Catherine Drexel. Now, St. Catherine Drexel is one of the few American saints, and she has a fascinating story. Now, perhaps in the world today, you've heard about an heiress. An heiress is a girl who belongs to a very rich family, and she gets to live, well, sort of the life of a fantasy. She gets to have anything she wants, and oftentimes she's famous and all sorts of things, gets to travel the world. Well, St. Catherine Drexel grew up that way. Her father was in finance and he was incredibly successful, and they were crazy wealthy. But she became a saint. So take a second and guess what she did when her father died and she inherited millions and millions of dollars. Well, she didn't go spend all that money on herself. Instead, she looked to the poor, to the poorest of the poor, to people that were completely overlooked and living in just terrible poverty. She especially went to help the Native Americans. St. Catherine Drexel gave all of her money eventually, over the course of her life, to help others. She became a religious sister, and her whole life was spent building hospitals and schools, and meeting individuals out in the world, being missionaries to them and loving them. St. Catherine Drexel is an incredible saint that teaches us the power of generosity, how wealth can do amazing things, but only when it is shared and when we do that good work with Jesus Christ. Now, this week on the Catholic Sprouts podcast, we are talking about our first vice, and that's anger. Yesterday, we talked about how anger can be just and good when we see evil in the world, and it motivates us to fight that evil. But it also can be a sin when it simply comes from us being offended or feeling like we've been overlooked. And it's particularly bad when it festers and becomes bitterness. It can end relationships. Now, here is the cool thing, my friends. In the Bible, we have several words that Jesus spoke directly from the cross. Take a minute and just realize how cool that is. Not only do we know that Jesus, God Himself, became man and died for us, but we get to hear what He says to us as He made this sacrifice. And here is what is even more amazing. The words that Jesus spoke on the cross directly address the major sins that we fight. He was human. He knew the struggles. And He also gave us the answer, the key for understanding how to fight those sins. So while He was on the cross, Jesus said these words. He said, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Now, first of all, wow. We can get offended about the tiniest little things. You took the bigger piece of pie. Hey, that's my sweater. You didn't even ask to borrow it, right? We can get so angry about these silly little things. Jesus refused to be angry even when He was being crucified and He was completely innocent. Now, this one sentence that Jesus said from the cross gives us two important lessons on anger. The first lesson is this: we don't know what is going on in other people's minds, and we don't have the right to be angry. Now, here's what I mean. Look at what Jesus said. He said, "Father, forgive them." But why? "Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they are doing." He asked God to forgive all of these people that had just nailed Him to the cross because they didn't know. Now, if we extended this to other people in our lives, would we ever have a reason to be angry? If we said, God, forgive my sister for spilling something all over my brand new shirt. She didn't know it was an accident. God, forgive this friend for saying something mean about me behind my back. She was having a really bad day. God, forgive my mom for not remembering to help me with my school project. She's really busy. Right? There's always a reason why these things happen in our life that make us so angry. That reason is almost never that they wanted to make you mad or that they wanted to upset you. There is always something going on in someone else's life. And more often than not, we don't even know what that thing is. So if Jesus Christ can hang on the cross and refuse to be angry at the people that have just crucified him, he finds a reason to forgive them. Don't you think there's a reason that you can forgive others and not get trapped in the sin of anger? And so, Sprouts, this is my challenge for you today, and really my challenge for you for the rest of your life. Think of the person that just makes you so mad, that one person that makes you more angry than other people. Maybe it's a little brother and sister, maybe it's a friend, or maybe it's someone in your class. They just get on your nerves and make you so mad. Take a second and consider things from their perspective. What might be going on for them that makes them do things that make you mad? And maybe there's a reason for it, a reason worth forgiving them. So take a second and think about that.
That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow, but until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God created you to be.
Hey there, I hope you're having a blessed and holy Lent. If you're looking for some more very simple ideas, I encourage you to go to catholicsprouts.com/Lent. There are a lot of simple, free ideas that families can use, and they're great for classrooms as well.